to start it over. I want to start again. I want a new beginning, one without an end. I feel it inside calling out to me. It's a voice that whispers my name. It's a kiss without any shame. Something beautiful, like a song that stirs in my head. Singing love will take us where. Something beautiful. I heard it in the silence. I seen it on a face. I felt it in the long hour, like a sweet embrace. I know this is true, it's calling out to me. It's a voice that whispers my name. It's a kiss without any shame. Something beautiful, like a song that stirs in my head. Singing love will take us where. Something beautiful. It's a child on a wedding day. It's a daddy that gives her away. Something beautiful. When we laugh so hard we cry. It's the love between you and I. Something beautiful. It's a voice that whispers my name. It's a kiss without any shame. Something beautiful. Like a song that stirs in my head. Singing love will take us where. Something beautiful. It's the child on a wedding day. It's the daddy that gives her away. Something beautiful. When we laugh so hard we cry. It's a love between you and I. Something beautiful. Something beautiful. Something beautiful.
Good morning, everybody. We are Dan and Carla, and we're so happy that you joined us today. It's raining here in Iowa, Spirit Lake, Iowa, so hopefully wherever you're tuning in from, it's nicer there than it is here. The next song that we're going to do is a song that Dan just wrote. It's called Pray, and I think it's really needed right now because sometimes you just want to pray, and if you're anything like me, you feel like you're not very good at it, and so that's where this song came from. And you'll recognize a few of the verses come from the Lord's Prayer. So join us when we do the Lord's Prayer.
I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. We live in a time when love is a maybe. Forget how to love when the world turns crazy. Love never changes, but people turn hazy. Oy vey, I say, I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. Sing it now. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven. I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. You're the ones that we need the most. Rest for the weary is on the way. Speechless, gotta pray. A prayer for the day is a prayer that we say. Oh, I say, I really wanna pray. I really wanna pray, pray. Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven. I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. This day, our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray. I really wanna pray. I really wanna pray, pray. Sing it now. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth. Sing it now. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven. I really want to pray. I really want to pray, pray.
Amen. Awesome. Great song, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very cool. Welcome, everyone. Good morning, and welcome to our live stream worship. My name is Tammy. I am the Director of Discipleship and Christian Education here at Spirit Lake United Methodist Church. We are glad that you are joining us, however that may be, and from wherever that may be. I do want to just give a quick shout out and say congratulations to all the graduates, the class of 2020, who would be graduating technically today, and we just wish them all the best of luck. And we had a lot of college graduates from our church family this year too, so congratulations to all of you. We wish you all of the best. At this time, before we begin our worship, I would invite you to join me in lighting a candle and representing the light of Christ being with us wherever we are joining from, whether that's via your phone or your laptop or your smart TVs, however it is that you can see us this morning and worship with us, let's light a candle together. Let's pray. Lord, we come to you today in praise of your holy name and give you thanks for all of the ways that you bless us. In this time where we find ourselves in need of comfort, we know you are with us and your Holy Spirit is our comforter. Father God, grant us patience in these days. Amen.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And
Morning, Tammy.
Good morning, Poco.
How are you this morning?
Well, I'm doing great. How are you?
He says he's driving Mom a little nuts with all the rain. Mom wants to kick him out, but you can't really go out because you come in and you smell like wet monkey. And that's worse than wet dog. Thanks for sharing, Poco.
Yeah, it's been a couple rainy days, hasn't it? Definitely. You know, I was going to talk about today, we've been talking about how after Jesus rose from the dead on Easter morning, then he came back and he appeared to his disciples and he appeared to other people. And so today I was going to talk about how when Jesus was giving his disciples instructions so that they would be fine while he went back to heaven to be with God, his Father. But, you know, and along with that, though, as I was coming in this morning, it was really windy. And I think it must have been really windy last night because the dumpster from over by Wesley Place, I don't know, did you see this?
It was in the middle of the parking lot.
I know.
Where somebody's going to run into it.
It's crazy. I'm glad my car, that's about where I usually park my car, so I'm glad my car wasn't parked there when it happened.
That would have hurt.
Yeah, that wouldn't have been fun, would it? So it got me thinking about the wind and how...
Stop that. What were you doing? Oh, you're preening. Okay, excuse me.
You know how the wind, we can't really see wind, right? But we can see what the wind does. We saw that the wind blew that dumpster across the parking lot. Do you see flags? And you know that if they're moving, it's because of the wind. We don't see the wind, but we see what the wind does. The trees.
The neighbor's kiddie pool blowing across the backyard. Yep. The grill cover from across the street blowing through the yard.
Yeah. Absolutely, all those things. So we can't see the wind, but we know that there is wind because we can see what it does. And it reminds me of the gift that Jesus left for us when he went back to be with his Father God. Do you know what that gift is, Poco?
It must have something to do with wind.
Yeah, it's the Holy Spirit. You see, the Holy Spirit, we can't see it.
Poco wants to know if that's like Ghostbusters.
Well, not exactly like Ghostbusters. The Holy Spirit...
Because you really like Ghostbusters, and you especially like the Ghostbusters with all the girls. They were really cool. Yeah, okay.
Good movies. That'll give me something to do maybe later this afternoon while it's raining. Maybe I can rewatch those. Anyway, so the Holy Spirit, we can't see the Holy Spirit, but it's there. And you know how we know it's there? One, God told us, and Jesus told us that it was there, but also because we know we can tell what the Holy Spirit does. And the Holy Spirit gives us comfort when we know we have that Holy Spirit with us and gives us help when we need it. We see what it does in the way that we feel comforted, and we see it in the kindness of strangers. You know, that's all those things are the Holy Spirit working in and through us, even though we can't see it.
Like when strangers are wearing a mask at the grocery store.
Yes, that's them being helpful.
Yeah, maybe you should wear a mask next Sunday. Good idea.
So even though we don't see it, we feel and know that the Holy Spirit is with us. Let's pray. Can you repeat after me, please? Awesome. Father God, even though we don't see, we feel and know that you are with us. Thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit that comforts us always. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks, Poco. Our scripture reading this morning comes from Luke chapter 24, beginning with verse 44. Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law from Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. He said to them, "This is what is written. The Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and a change of heart and life for the forgiveness of sins must be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. Look, I'm sending to you what my Father promised, but you are to stay in the city until you have been furnished with heavenly power. He led them out as far as Bethany, where he lifted his hands and blessed them. As he blessed them, he left them and was taken up to heaven. They worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem, overwhelmed with joy. And they were continuously in the temple praising God. And from Acts chapter 1, beginning with verse 1. Theophilus, the first scroll I wrote concerned everything Jesus did and taught from the beginning, right up to the day when he was taken up into heaven. Before he was taken up, working in the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus instructed the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed them that he was alive with many convincing proofs. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days, speaking to them about God's kingdom. While they were eating together, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father had promised. He said, "This is what you heard from me. John baptized with water, but in only a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." As a result, those who had gathered together asked Jesus, "Lord, are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel now?" Jesus replied, "It isn't for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has set by his own authority. Rather, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth." After Jesus said these things, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going away, and as they were staring toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood next to them. They said, "Galileans, why are you standing here looking toward heaven? This Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way that you saw him go into heaven." The words of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Good morning, church. I'm Pastor Vicki, and at Spirit Lake United Methodist Church, we are here to make disciples and to make a difference. So this week, I kept seeing this pop-up advertisement on social media saying, maximize your lower third, engage your audience. And the advertisement was for facilities where they have switchers, where they could put like a little banner at the bottom of services like this, a running banner that tells people where to click and what to find. And hope that you check out our website, by the way. And have you been an evangelist yet this morning? Have you clicked share? Please do. Yes, we appreciate that. And let us know you're here. And I have one question I want you to think about, maybe you can even comment on here, is what are you waiting for today? Going back to the lower third, I thought, if I had a lower third, if we had the capacity here to do the switchers and to throw in lower thirds, what might show up on Pastor Vicky's lower third? What did I forget? I'm asking this almost every Sunday morning, what have I forgotten? It's sort of interesting because I can write down notes to myself, but sometimes I get up here and they just drift away and they just all sort of run together. This would be on my lower third. Do I have something in my teeth? I hope they're not zoomed in too close because, you know, this would be in my lower third. Wow, have you seen the lilacs and the crab apples lately? Oh my goodness, they're just everywhere and they're just so happy and the air is just so full of pollen that my voice is cracking and my nose is running, but the crab apples and the lilacs, no thank you Jesus for spring. Okay. On my lower third, 2021 will be our year. Or if I truly was a televangelist, give now. give now, give now, give, 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 give now. Or, well, to be honest, seriously, check out the website. It's really easy to give now from the website. And you know, if the message is boring, I won't know you're not paying attention. You can mute the pastor. You can't do that when you're sitting in the pews. Oh, wow, okay. Something else that would be at my lower third. Oh, shoot, folks. You know, I laugh. And I love to laugh, but this is hard. That would be in my lower third. Oh, I miss you. Are you okay? Call me. Tell me things. Let me pray for you. Oh, here we go. This would also be in my lower third. Does this color make me look washed out on Facebook? Is white better or green? White or green? Do you remember doing that when you were like in high school? The makeup lady would come and you would do your season, right? And they'd put up color swatches, and some color swatches would make you look sick. If I wear purple, people ask me, are you feeling all right? You don't look very good. So I guess I'm not supposed to wear purple. Oh, and the last one, just because I love the outdoors, on my lower third it would say, wow, spring is everywhere. You just can't get away from it. Isn't it great? So what are you waiting for today? And do you like to wait? Do you like to wait? I've never met a person who likes to wait. So if you're that person who likes to wait, I want to meet you and wave at you from an appropriate social distance. There we go. I've heard it said by several people this past week, I just wish there was something I could do to make things better, something other than washing your hands and wearing a mask. I wish there was something more I could do. I wish I could fast forward to when this is all over and skip the hard parts. How do you feel about waiting rooms? Now, I understand that out at the clinic, the waiting room is your car, and you basically go from your car to an exam room when you have to go in. But, you know, back in the day of regular waiting rooms and regular waiting in the waiting rooms, there's a story about a fellow who was visiting a clinic to which he was a prominent donor. He had given all the bucks. He had his name on the biggest plaque out there, you know, well known in the community, and he was waiting for a doctor's appointment and waiting and waiting. And finally, he goes up to the office manager and he says, I've been waiting too long. I want to see the doctor next. And the kind woman said, sir, you'll have to wait your turn just like everyone else. And the major donor said, ma'am, do you know who I am? And without missing a beat, she presses the intercom and she says, attention, we have a fellow here in the waiting room who does not know his identity. If you can help, could you please come to the waiting room? Now, I imagine that's not really a true story. But you know, you've seen the type where you've been waiting patiently and patiently and somebody budges the line and you resent that just a little bit, or maybe a whole lot. Yes, waiting. I've had a few people mention to me over the course of this pandemic, do you think we're in the last days? And I say to them, well, I don't know. People have been talking about the last days since the time of Christ. And I know that whether it's the last days or not, I still have to do what God has called me to do. In the same way, at the end of the book of Luke and the beginning of the book of Acts, these two volumes that were written by Luke, the physician, to his Greek friend Theophilus, the disciples were recorded as asking Jesus this question after his resurrection. Lord, is it time now for you to restore the kingdom of Israel? In other words, they're asking, is this the last days when Jesus comes and makes everything right and we all get to be kings and we live happily ever after and there's no more sin, sickness, sadness, death, sorrow, or Roman soldiers crucifying Israel criminals on crosses? And Jesus replied, these words are hard. He said, it's not for you to know the time or the hour that the Father has set by his own authority. We don't know how long, but the question is then, how do we wait well? How do we wait well for what comes next? What do we do when we're ready to go back to work, when we're itching to go back to normal, But we have to wait. We have to wait well. So the promise is that Jesus said, wait in Jerusalem and you would receive the Holy Spirit. He tells this to his followers. He says, don't go out and do anything great now. Don't go back fishing, Peter. Stay in Jerusalem, stay together, and wait. Today would be the Sunday we would celebrate the Ascension of Christ, traditionally, if we were following the lectionary. And then a couple weeks, it will be Pentecost Sunday. But there's a space there between when Jesus has disappeared up into heaven and the disciples are all going, until finally an angel says, what are you watching for? The same Jesus who ascended will return in the same way. You're like, come on, guys, get on with your life. He's not coming back like in 5 minutes. He's not like, you know, when your wife says she's going out for groceries and she'll be back in a half hour, and 2 hours later you're like, okay, who did she run into? This is Jesus, and he's gone, and his disciples are stunned. And the angel says, don't keep standing here, doofus, go. Okay, that's the Fisher paraphrase once again. It doesn't actually say doofus in the Bible. But you get that impression, though, that the disciples were all watching where Jesus had disappeared and not doing anything until the angel says, move along, folks. Nothing to see here. And Jesus tells them to wait. So what can we do while we're waiting? There are three things from the book of Acts, from chapter 1 of Acts, that I think stand out to me that maybe might be helpful to you today. The first one is to remember who you are, to remember your call. Jesus says to the disciples, you will be my witnesses. Basically saying, no, Peter, you're not going back to fishing. No matter how much you love that work, you're going to be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, and all Samaria, into the very ends of the earth. And I remind myself, what are we called as God's people? Who are we as God's baptized children claimed by God? It would be important for us to stop right now and remember who we are if we have to wait, that we are not identified by our job, our money, our reputation, our power, that our identity lies in Christ Jesus, who has claimed us and has called us his very own children, God who has named us beloved. Paul put it this way, he said, behold what manner of love the Father has given to us, that we would be called children of God. You are more than your income. You are more than your position. You are more than what you can do for your family. You are a beloved child of God. No matter how low you are today, no matter how high you are today, no matter if you're on the outs or you're on the inside, you are called by God and named as one of God's beloved children. You matter to God. You are precious to God. The scripture in Isaiah 49 says God has carved you into the very palm of God's hand. You know, think about how hard it is to work when you got your hands full. It's like God is always thinking of you, having you in his very palm of his hand, that God doesn't ever stop thinking about you. So while you're waiting, remember your call. Remember who you are. That you are more than just all these labels. You are beloved child of God. I also like to remember who we are. We can look back on our life and see how we have gotten through. We've gotten through hard times in the past. Many of you have a long track record of facing things that you didn't know how to get through, yet here you are today, and you need to remember the same God that took you through that indescribable moment, indescribable season is here and now, and that God will get you through. This is one of the things that I worry about our young people sometimes. See, I'm nearly 50, and I can look back, and I know God has always gotten us through. It might have been heartbreaking. It might have been extremely difficult at times, but God has always taken us through. And some of our young people, they don't have years of experience to lean on, to know that they're going to be okay. And some of us need to come alongside our young folks and say, hey, hang in there. You are going to make it through. The bad times don't last. Tough times don't last. Another thing we can look at in Acts chapter 1 is the disciples were together. There's like 120 people gathered there. Now, nowadays, we can't get together, right? I know, underneath one roof, but But we have all the opportunities that they didn't have back in Acts 1. We have our telephones, we have email and texting, we have Skype and Facebook Live, we have all these Zoom ways of connecting with people. Isn't Zoom fun to say? Zoom. Anyways, we have all these ways of connecting with people. Are you staying connected? Are you staying connected with folks? Are you making calls? Are you reaching out? If you're having a hard time, are you reaching out for help? Are you telling folks, you know, you're a little concerned? In Ecclesiastes, it says, a cord of three strands is not easily broken, that we are bound together and stronger together. Even if we can't be here together, we can be there for each other. So who are you watching out for? Who are you encouraging? Are you reaching out when you need encouragement? Remember who we are and stick together. Stick together. And then I'd also remind you of God's promise and God's timing. Jesus said to the disciples, you would receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And he didn't tell them when. So many times we know that the answer is coming. We know that our prayers will be answered. We know that we will find strength, that we'll find grace, but it's not here yet. Remember the promise of God, the promise that God said he'd never leave you or forsake you, that his eye is always upon you, that we are called during this time to be part of the good works God is doing. I'm also reminded of Isaiah, where the prophet says about God, my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways your ways. As the heavens are high above the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. So when you don't know what God is up to, lean into that not knowing. Lean into God's strong hands that are carrying you. Lean into God's promises, knowing that you are called as a beloved child of God, that you are not alone, that there is hope and help out there, both to give and to receive, and know that God is not done yet. There's a promise made to the disciples, made to these who were cowards, who were doubting, who were scattered, to come back together and hold into hope and believe that the Holy Spirit would give them strength. There was this meme that went around a while back and makes its rounds every once in a while. It talks about, you know, you're walking along with a cup of coffee and somebody bumps you. And what sloshes over? Coffee. Some of you have hit a big bump. You've been bumped. And some of you are sloshing over anxiety and fear and hopelessness and loneliness. I want to remind you that you are not alone. The God of the universe knows who you are, that you still have a church, that you still are beloved, that you still matter, that help is still available, and that if we can fill ourselves with God's love and grace and hope, maybe the next time we're bumped, we'll slosh over a little bit of love and gentleness on people, because God has filled us with love. There's a promise that God doesn't call the powerful. God doesn't call people who have their lives together. Instead, he invites those who are afraid, those who have doubts. He invites them to stay together, to pray together, to wait, and that he would send the power that they need. It's sort of like, you know, having a phone and having it be totally drained. The power is never from us. The power is from getting plugged into the power source. And it's God who invites us to stop for a while. Remember who we are during this time. Remember whose we are. Remember that we are not alone. And remember the promises of God saying there's power coming when you are powerless. There's hope coming when you are hopeless. There is a future coming for you that is blessed and full of hope. You are not alone. How are you waiting today? Are you doing a good job waiting, church? Are you waiting with hope? Are you waiting with prayer? Are you reaching out to wait with other Christians, other people? How are you waiting? Let's pray. God, God, we read the numbers that have died across the world. We read the nearly 80,000 deaths in our country. And we mourn, God. We read about joblessness, about domestic violence increasing, about mental health concerns, and we mourn, oh God. We read about our seniors, and we think about all the things that they are missing. And we hope, oh God, for all the things that lie ahead, for weddings, more graduations, for achievements and academics, for jobs and hope. And we know that good things are coming, but we pray for our seniors, both in high school and college, that you would watch over them and carry them through. God, in our church family, we also lift up Laura Johnson, who lost her sister in Michigan this past week. God, watch over Laura and her family. We also lift up Annette Fairchild, who's had a major health crisis this week and is nearing death. God, for all these dear ones, for the unnameable thousands that have been lost, hear the prayer of our hearts as we pray together the prayer Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Are there more announcements? What next with Tammy?
All right. Just want to remind you of the things that we have happening in the life of our church this week. I would like you to check your calendars, and that is on our website, so you can check the calendar there for meetings that are happening, or check with your committee chair just to see if your committee is meeting this month. Or you can call the church office, and I'm sure Deb would love to help you with that. Tuesday, there is live with Pastor Vicki at 1 p.m. on Facebook. And on Wednesday, Pastor Vicki will have a Zoom coffee at 11 a.m. I will go live with a short message at 5:30 p.m. And then we have a drive-in service Wednesday evening at 6:30 p.m. That is where you come and drive into the parking lot and park. Leave your windows up, tune to 88.1 FM, and Pastor Vicki will have a service for us. Thursday, I have the Women's Bible Study at 2 p.m. If you're involved in that, I'll be sending out information on the Facebook group as far as what to expect with that. And then next Sunday, we have our 8:30 family room worship, 10:30 sanctuary worship, both our live stream. Again, congratulations, graduates. Have a great day.
Thanks, Tammy. Be sure to like our Facebook page, check out the website. Friends, until we are gathered in this way again, may God our Father bless you and keep you, make his face to shine upon you, be gracious to you, and grant you his peace. I ask this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
To think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord done. I want to be thankful, I want to be grateful, I want to be, I want to be, I want to be. to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. I just want to lift my hand and say that I love Him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, want to be, want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, 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 want to be.